Keyhole. If you don't know what it is, let me tell you what it is. What it is the show in which I go around celebrities' houses unearthing vital clues so our celebrity panel here in the studio can guess whose house it is. It's as simple as peas. Anyway, with further ado, let's meet our panel. First up, it's Steve McDonald! McDonald from Coronation Street. That's not your real name, that's a character you play. What's your real name in real life?
Simon Gregson.
Simon. Is it all right if I call you Stephen, though?
Call me whatever you want.
I'll call you Terry. Next up, she's a pop superstar. She's my favourite Saturday, apart from last week when I found £20 in my pocket. That was a nice Saturday. It's Mollie King! Finally! It's Dave Berry from Telly! Thanks, Steve. That's Simon. Simeon. If you could go through the keyhole of anyone on Coronation Street, which keyhole would you go through?
Difficult one. Probably Rita's, because she looks like she's got a comfortable interior.
Right. Now it's time to snoop around our first celebrity house. Watch closely for the clues, but I'll give you a clue. Not every clue is a clue. So without further ado, let's go through the keyhole. Let's go through the keyhole! The first VT will be going back for some more in a few minutes, but first I'm going to make the person whose home it is magically appear behind you. Don't look round and look, otherwise everything is defunct. There's no point in even doing this. They might as well put one of those dramas on with Saran Jones, who I'd like to go swimming with. So just don't look round. So for the audience here and the people at home, this is whose house it is. Sound of the audience applauding, that will be your closest ally. If you hear clapping, then you're closer. So the clappier they are, the closer you are. You really want the clap, right?
Right.
Simon, what do you want?
I want the clap.
Molly, what do you want?
I want the clap.
Right then, so first impressions from that.
First impressions are, when you revealed to the audience and everyone at home who it was, Molly went, "They all seem to like him."
Yeah.
So I think we know it's not a serial killer or anyone who's done anything bad. It's not a serial killer or anyone's done anything bad.
Simon, your first impressions?
Well, first thing I noticed were the cars.
Yes,
the cars. I'm guessing someone with that amount of cars does something with balls. Because people who do things with balls tend to have a lot of flash cars.
That makes sense.
Or to look at it the other way, Simon, which I think is that sometimes they say a car represents, you know, something that a man might be lacking.
Yeah.
Something God given. So he's going, "Here, look, my five cars."
So it's someone with loads of cars and a small hidden area.
I'm saying, if this man
has... clapping out you now, big deal.
We're already saying that... Do we know it's a he?
I don't know.
I've got to be a he.
I think it's a sportsman with all those trophies.
Well, OK, let's sum it up. You think it's not a serial killer. You think it's someone with loads of cars and a small hidden area. And he's a sports person that does something with balls.
Yeah.
OK, well, let's go through keyhole again. So, Molly, let's start with you. What are you getting there?
I mean, I'm stuck here because we know he's a sportsman. He's quite into his fashion, I think.
Sorry. All of his stuff that Keith tried on didn't look out of place. Just think about that.
His clothes do not... Dave.
I'm sorry. We haven't established what sport it is, have we?
No.
Footballer, I'm going for.
I think footballer, because he had a football by the trophies.
What about... what's he called again, that boxer? The shorts you had him on.
Madame Dali. Madame Dali shots.
Did they clap when I said boxer?
I'm so glad he's got a little penis.
So it's a boxer with a tiny willy.
No, it's a well-hung boxer who's very, very successful with the ladies if he chooses to be.
Yeah.
And an incredible house.
Any guesses?
Okay, boxers. Let's think. Is it a British boxer?
Is he a northern lad?
Is he quite good looking?
Yeah, I second that. Let's stop your messing. Let's get guessing. Who is it?
I reckon it's Ricky Hatton.
I don't think it's Ricky Hatton.
No? Not that's the only boxer I know, so I'm out.
No, I know the boxer.
Muhammad Ali.
Oh, apart from Muhammad Ali.
Is it Amir Khan?
That's correct. Olympic silver medalist and boxing champion Amir Khan. Please come through Keyhole.
My next opponent.
Hi, Amy.
Are you all right?
You look lovely.
Thanks for letting me go around your house.
I didn't know if to smile or not when I saw you put them Muhammad Ali shorts on. You know how much it cost me?
Well, you can get them from JD Sports, can't you?
It's like getting them signed by Muhammad Ali because he stopped signing. Muhammad Ali doesn't sign anything anymore, so you don't say you really put them on and jumped in the pool.
Yeah, I did, yeah.
You're in more trouble than I am.
But I'll tell you what, I've got a present to say sorry for your shorts. Seeing as though you collect shorts, it's some of my shorts.
I'll put them there instead.
There you go, that's for you, Annie.
Come on, thank you.
Put them next to Muhammad Ali.
I'll put them right next to Muhammad Ali.
So, yes, you built a big stonking house. Was that your mum's house?
That's right, yeah. So I literally live right opposite them. I had loads of land there, so I built an annex there with a pool house downstairs and everything. Yeah. So I'm not too far away from them, but I'm not living the same.
Yeah, but you block out all the sun.
Was
she all right with that then?
Yeah, she was cool. She was all right. She was a sunbathe. She has to come to my side of the house.
What about the food in the fridge that was all labelled?
Yes.
What the hell is that about?
When I'm on a diet and stuff, like depending how far I am away from a fight, I like to put days
Do you label the food?
My sister does everything.
Your sister does?
She's good lad. She knows how serious it gets to, you know, making weight and stuff, because if you don't make weight, then you don't fight.
Right.
So, you know, especially after you've trained for like 10 weeks and you have to make sure you do everything perfect. You can't cheat yourself.
Yeah, what's your proper job then when you're not having a fight then? You just say, I'm eating Kit Kats.
Got all my diet food, haven't we?
Look at that!
Yeah, got my sweet dry. You know what? Us fighters need that because we're always on a diet when we're in training camp.
You're not on a diet if you're eating Yorkies and Kit Kats and Snickers.
But it's always good to go back home and you can kind of eat what you want and pig out a little bit.
That's a documentary waiting to happen. So what's next for Amir Khan?
Next for me is a fight in December. So I'm going to start quite early and go back to America because I train over there now.
Oh, you train in America? Why not? Bolton, America. I'll go America.
But you know, it's funny because I got married and stuff, so my wife asked me to live with her in New York.
Oh, does she live in New York?
Yeah, she's from New York originally.
She's moved from New York to Bolton?
That's right, yeah. I said, look, you have to go back to, own little gym there for the community and stuff. Okay. So I said, listen, you have to move to Bolton. She's like, really?
Never mind New York, Bolton. Well, Amir, I'd just like to say thanks for letting you be in your beautiful home. I'd like to live there. It's my dream to be you. Amir Khan, everyone! I would like to present Amir with this wonderfully crafted, gold-coloured, fruit-keel keyring. Ooh!
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, panel, congratulations on guessing whose house it was. To be honest, though, it couldn't have been easier because I said his name twice.
You did it.
Did you? Let's have a look at this.
I'm here in the kitchen. I'm here in the gym.
Join us after the break when we'll be going through more keels. So see you in a bit. All best. So, here I am in the bathroom, as you can see. It's very minimalist. Is this a clue? Or is it just a red herring? Hello, how's How's your mum? Is she well? She looks good. Welcome back to Through the Keyhole in part one. We popped to Amir Khan's house and discovered that he built a gigantic bachelor pad bang in the middle of his mum's house's garden. She can't see nothing. She is well vexed, boy. Our panel managed to guess correctly, so well done to them.
Thank
well
you.
Done. Dave, who's the most famous keyhole you've ever been in? Gone through. Who's the most famous house you've ever been in?
Been in the Kings of Leon's house.
Have you?
Been in all of their houses.
Yeah.
Very impressive. I had spaghetti bolognese with the drummer.
No way. Yeah. Mollie, what about you? You must have been in some famous people's houses.
No, I haven't really.
Yeah, you must just lie then.
I made up the Kings of Leon thing just because of what I'm doing.
I'm at Madonna's all the time.
Are you?
Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing. When you go into character as Steve,
yeah,
what triggers it off? What makes you go, I'm in character now, call me Steve?
Moments of madness, drunkenness.
Are you in character now?
No, I'm Simon Stroke Terry now.
Why are you doing the voice of Steve McDonald?
Because I like to keep the illusion alive for the audience at home, you know.
Now it's time to have a look around our next celebrity home. And for this one, we've gone to LA. OK, panel, keep your eyes peeled, cos not all the clues are clues, as we go to another famous gaff when we go right now, Through the Keyhole. OK, that was the VT panel. Remember, no peeking. We're going to reveal whose house it is for the studio audience and people at home. This is whose house it is. Don't look round. Dave, as I went through the keyhole, what leapt out at you?
Well, my first impression is we've answered the age-old question of do celebrities shit in the woods? Because it seems yes. Yes, they do. That's my first impression. What have you got, Molly?
Well, I think they live alone because there's just one hammock there. Obviously not a chef because there's not many cooking devices. Yeah. I think it's a man. I didn't see many feminine products there, but well,
you didn't get the clap there.
Is it a woman?
It's a woman who's here.
Simon, what about you? What's your observations?
I put LA and poor.
They're poor and they're from LA. No clapping!
We've already established this woman. Very boho in that kind of...
Yeah.
...environment.
OK, so let's sum it up so far. This person is not a chef. They're a lady. They're from LA. So let's rejoin me for some more clues as I go back through the keyhole. You observe, Dave.
You do know that's an outside toilet that you got in and used as a bath, don't you?
No, they didn't have a toilet. They didn't have a toilet.
So celebrities do shit in the woods?
No, they just keep it in.
We kind of clocked the samurai sword thing, and just as we were talking, heard you say, take your eye out. We're thinking that she's an actress. may know somebody called Quentin.
It's a female American actress
who's probably been in the film Kill Bill.
She's been in the film Kill Bill. And if I'm not mistaken, The Red Flippers, because she was also in one of my favourite films of all time. She was in Splash.
Yes. Stop your messing and finish your guessing. And who is it?
It is, of course, the one and only Daryl Hannah.
That's correct. It's Hollywood superstar, Daryl Hannah!